Hello again, Blair Bear fans, and welcome to today's doubleheader with the Blair Bears taking on the Ralston Rams. The Blair Bear girls will take on the Rams first, and then the boys will follow. Thanks for joining us here today as the Rams coming in here at 0-1 here so far on the season. Blair comes in at 1-0, and Ralston lost their first contest against York, 64-38, and the Blair Bears defeated Mercy 64-48 to tap off their opener. And we want to thank everybody here for joining us here today on BlairSports.net and American Broadband Channel 97, 98 HD. And, of course, on YouTube, /BSDN Live. So go there, and you'll be able to pick up all the live action on YouTube. And, of course, it's video action today, audio action. I don't know if you want the audio, but you're going to get it along with the video. I'm Jim Lockery, along with Shane Morrison.
Well, I do have a lot of people tell me it's a much more enjoyable to watch a sporting event with some commentary. So that's why they keep us around.
That's a good thing. The Ralston Rams coming off a 4-18 season last year. The Blair Bears at 10-13. Last year, Blair won this one 50-33. And but you look at the Ralston Rams this year, and there's a couple of different young ladies out there that 6'2", 6'1", not too short. And so the Blair Bears may want to turn this into a track meet.
Well, and that's what they did last year. They did have some height last year, and that's what they did last year. Just get up and down court and make them run.
Yeah.
Usually the taller you are, the harder it is for you to get up and down court. That's not always true.
Yeah.
You know, Kevin Garnett can get up and down the court pretty well.
Well, yes.
But for the most part, especially at the high school level, it's a rare athlete you can see that can run the court and be tall. So that's what you want to do. Get up and run. See if they can stay with you. Because the one thing that Coach Eckwalt has as a trademark of his teams, they like to get out and run. They like to push the ball. They like to have that up-tempo pace. It's an exciting brand of basketball to watch, and I enjoy it a lot.
Let's take a look at the Ralston Rams as head coach Natalie Buchta will get these five ladies out there tonight, or this afternoon, I guess. I have to remember that we are here in the afternoon, and we want to thank everybody for joining us here today. Jade Adler is a 5'7 junior, will start things out. 5'9 senior Randy Henry, and a 6'2 junior Lauren Shimkowitz. So Shimkowitz is a 6'2 junior. And then Clara Kaz is a 6'1 senior. Sarah Zarinski is a 5'6 senior. And that is the starting lineup for the Ralston Rams. For the Blair Bears tonight, 5'3 senior Allie Rosenbaum will start things out. 5'5 sophomore Morgan Shang. Morgan had 23 points the other night in the opener, and that was definitely a track meet for the Blair Bears. 5'3 senior Taylor Stewart starting things out. And a 5'9 senior Bailey Wakefield rounds out the starting lineup for head coach Sean Eckwall and assistant coach John Small. The boys will play immediately after this, and we'll have the playing of the national anthem coming up. We'll be right back with a tip-off right here on BlairSports.net and American Broadband Channel 97, 98 HD.
Gathered to
singing of the national anthem. Fantastic job. And the Blair Bears getting ready to take on the Ralston Rams. It's always great to have a student stand up and sing that national anthem a cappella.
Well, I wouldn't try it. You got a lot of respect for somebody who can stand up there in front of all these people and bang out the national anthem like that.
Absolutely, no doubt about it. So the Blair Bears. Starting lineup being announced here, as you see, and so we'll be ready to go here shortly with the Blair Bears. We want to thank American Broadband, your hometown internet, cable television, telephone provider, American Broadband, serving all of your communication needs.
5'3", senior
number 22, Taylor Stewart. Blair Bears being announced now, and of course the cheerleaders lining up, and good crowd has filled it in here, Shane.
Well, it's the first home game of the year, I believe, isn't it?
It's the second.
It's for the girls, it's the second, yeah. But we got a doubleheader Saturday afternoon.
Yeah.
The Huskers aren't playing.
So unfortunately, they're not playing in the Big Ten. But
and to top that off, they got the Junior Bears at halftime of the girls' game, so you're going to get a pretty full crowd, I think, for this
absolutely.
One.
Absolutely, no doubt about it. It's good to see a good crowd coming out, and, of course, it's great entertainment. Come on down, and if you can, come in and watch the doubleheader. We're just underway here for the Blair girls. The Blair boys will follow, but if not, of course, you can watch us right here on blairsports.net. And American Broadband Channel 97, 98.
Well, and this place could get really packed by the time the boys start.
Yep.
There's a lot of anticipation for that boys' season this year. Not to jump ahead, but this could get really packed in here before this day's done.
Wakefield jumping against Shimkiewicz. Ball gets away. Ooh, Rosenbaum almost comes up with a steal. And then Shank gets it, brings it up to the top of the key, and finally gets control. Kicks it over to Stewart a little bit high. And it's out of bounds, so two turnovers start things out, and Ralston ends right back up with the ball.
Well, and that's one of the things you'll see, you know, especially early in the season with an up-tempo kind of offense. Sometimes those passes aren't quite as crisp as they will be later in the season.
Adler swings, first shot on the way off the front of the rim, no good. Rebound pulled down. Henry with that shot for the Ralston Rams. Here comes Shank. Shank brings it up on the right side. Top of the key now, gets into the paint, underneath to Wakefield. Goes up for the shot, and Shimkiewicz knocks that one away.
Well, and that's the one thing they're going to have to get accustomed to is you got that height in there, so she can erase some shots. Looked like she had a chance at a shot there, but that height just took it away.
Stewart, 15 feet away, and drops it down for two. So Stewart opens things up, knocks down 2 points, and it's 2-0 Blair. Just underway, 7:07 remaining here in the first. Ralston with the ball. Zawinski passes it inside. The shot on the way by Adler, no good. Rebound on the backside, picked up by Goss. Fed inside, turnaround shot off the rim, no good by Shimkiewicz. Wakefield brings it up, gives it up to Rosenbaum. Shank, left side, Stewart. Stewart comes out. Wakefield gets blasted out of the lane. Shank has it, comes off the pick, drives into the paint, stops, feeds Wakefield, quick shot, good, and she's fouled. She'll go to the line to complete the three-point play. They're going to count.
Quick little replay for you on that shot right there.
And there
we go.
That's
a new thing we got for basketball season here, folks, a quick little instant replay for you. We tried that one out there, and it worked.
Free throw by Wakefield, no good. Rebound pulled down, instant replay. Can't beat it right here, blairsports.net. Feet inside, double team. Stewart steps in, takes the ball away, gets it up to Shank. Shank goes in on the right side, lays it up for two. So Morgan Shank knocks down two, and Blair's doing what they want to do. That up-tempo pace, they're up 6-0 here in the early going over Ralston with 6:12 remaining here in the first period. Want to thank Sid Dillon Chevrolet, Cargill, MAC, Mid-America Computer Corporation, Blair Basketball Club, Herder Orthodontics, Jim Ralph Agency, Blair Real Estate, Two Rivers Bank, Washington County Bank, also Heartland Family Dentistry, Nannen and Hart Physical Therapy, leader in sports medicine for over 20 years. Thank you so much for all your sponsorship. And I got to tell you, I got a couple of new wrinkles here. Shane has been working in between sessions here, between the fall and now the winter. Coming up with the instant replay, we want to thank you so much, Shane, for all your hard work there. And you might have another surprise for us as we keep going here, but maybe, maybe not. We won't say much until it happens. We know how that goes. Technology. It's great.
Oh, yeah.
Blair comes up with a turnover from Ralston. Stewart will inbounds. Shank brings the ball up. 1-2-2 type zone defense by Ralston. Kicks it out, swings it. Shank, baseline, shot off the rim, no good. Ball tipped away. Coming up with it. Shimkiewicz got it. Gets it over to Adler. Adler brings the ball up for the Rams. Man-to-man defense for the Blair Bears. Henry takes it on the left wing. Adler slides down. Works inside the paint. A little right-handed hook. No good. Rebound tipped away. Knocked out. And it's going to go out of bounds. And that's going to be off the leg of Henry. 5'9 senior for the Rams. So the Blair Bears will have it. Roach will enter the ball game now. Dallas, 5'8 sophomore.
Well, and Shank and Roach have had a pretty solid JV start to their careers as freshmen. A lot of anticipation to their high school careers.
Stewart with the three from the corner, and it went along, and then she tips it out. Shank comes up with it. Another skip pass. Oh, nice move. Stewart goes inside, takes the shot, hurries it just a little bit. Ball's on the floor, and Wakefield will jump with Goss. And so Blair will retain possession here in alternating possessions. 5:05 remaining. Stewart looks to inbound. Gets it. Shank, baseline. Nice shot. Boy, Morgan Shank working hard. Goes out. Couldn't get it. Found an opening, just stepped into that opening, got it, and a quick shot, and now it's 8-0 Blair. Zawinski swings the ball, Adler now looks, Henry at the top of the key, Goss feeds it underneath, a little left-handed hook shot, and now we're going to have a foul called, and I'm sure that's going to be on Wakefield. So Bailey picks up her first foul. Wakefield is 5'9". Shimkiewicz is 6'2". Gets the inbounds, puts it up for two. Shimkiewicz knocks down two, and boy, Blair cannot afford to allow that inside game to get going. There's a reach by Adler, and she'll be called for the foul. That'll be her first, team second. 4:32 remaining here in the first. Megan Zarinski will enter the game. Rosenbaum has it on the right side. Blair trying to diagonal. Dallas Roach shot, no good. Long rebound picked up by Shank. Baseline shot, kiss off the glass, no good. Rebound underneath by Wakefield. Ball tipped around. Dallas comes up with it. So the Blair Bears have been scrappy. Offensive rebounds. Rosenbaum tips it into Wakefield, and they're able to get the ball into Wakefield, but just too tall at that point. And Adler brings the ball up. Man-to-man defense for the Blair Bears. Rams working it around. Adler has it on the right side. Looks inside. Kicks the ball back out. Going baseline, the ball gets stripped away. Rosenbaum kicks it up for Stewart. Stewart on the right side pulls up for a short jumper. Oh, rims around, no good. Wakefield with a nice rebound goes up, and she's going to be fouled as Shimkiewicz will foul her. So, oh, they're going to call it on Henry. Oh, what do I know? I thought Shimkiewicz had it, but obviously Henry fouled. Doesn't matter. It's still two free throws. Wakefield, first one up. Good. No stats yet. Only one game under their belt. And then, of course, the boys, this will be their first. Second one, no good. Rebound. Shimkiewicz brings it down. Gets it out to Adler. Adler rocks it up. Picked up by Rosenbaum. On the right side. Feed inside. Shimkiewicz gets it. A little high-low action. There's a shot on the way, and we're going to have a foul called on Morgan Shank. And they're going to say it's before the shot, or after the shot, I think.
Well, she went to box her out,
yeah,
and shoved her out pretty good. And when you're out on the wing like that, that's a pretty easy call for the ref.
Henry looking to inbound for the Rams. Kicks the ball in. 15-footer on the way and good. So Zerwinski knocks down two.
Well, the thing going on early in this game, Jim, is that the Bears are definitely the aggressors in this game.
Oh, yeah. Shot on the way off the front of the rim. Rebound pulled down by the Blair Bears and fought for as Grantham got the rebound, put it back up, but no good. So Dallas Roach picks up her first.
Entering the game for the Bears, number 23, Molly Nickerson.
So Molly Nickerson back in along with Stewart, Morgan Shank, and Jessica Shank. Dallas Roach in there. Trying to make a move and gets hung up with Shank. Now driving, Henry goes in on the right side, takes the shot, no good. Nice job by Shimkiewicz. Shimkiewicz grabs that one. And it's 9-6. Blair leading by three. Shank trying to drive, kicks it over. In the corner, Dallas Roach goes baseline, and now we'll have a foul called. I think that will be on Zerwinski.
Well, that's what that height does for you right there, Jim.
Yeah.
Able to secure that rebound and put it right back in.
Nickerson steps out. Shank swings it around. Stewart from the corner. Good. And Taylor Stewart knocks down the first three of the ball game.
Well, and she's been a really solid shooter her entire career, so that's no surprise.
Little high-low action, and Shimkiewicz turns around, knocks down another two, and Blair just has no answer for that height once they get it down in that area, and it's just very difficult. And Roach knocks down two. That's a long two. Gives a little fist pump after that one. She is an animated player, no doubt about it.
Well, she's a really good athlete, and usually your extreme athletes like that play with some emotion, play with a little bit of it on their sleeve, and they're not afraid to show their excitement when things are going well for them.
A little high-low action, but Dallas Roach comes over to help on that one, just exactly what she has to do, and then tips the ball away. 1:24 remaining in the first, 14-8. Blair leading. Ralston inbounding under their own basket. Swings it out. Goss gets it to Adler. Adler steps back. Looks. Little high post action coming by Zerwinski. Swinging the ball. Adler has it on the left. Underneath, Zerwinski goes up for the shot, and she's going to be fouled. And that is Megan Zerwinski.
Let's go ahead and take a quick look at that three-pointer from Taylor Stewart here just a few seconds ago.
At the line to shoot two for the Rams, number 50, Megan Zerwinski.
Taylor, like you say,
they swing it around the top here, all the way around, back into the corner. Stewart's the one that threw it in and hits that three-pointer in that three-pointer in the corner. Great play right there from the Bears.
Yeah. Good ball movement, gave time so that Stewart could get set.
Got her feet set. Yeah. You can see that on the replay. She got her feet underneath of her, put the shot up nice and clean.
Zerwinski made the first one, rims out the second one. And underneath, we have a foul called as
fouls on number 33, Dallas Roach.
So Rich picks up her second. Roach does, and that's number two.
Well, and that's where you got to box out and get that big body in there like that. Any kind of semi-long rebound, and she's just going to be able to secure it pretty easy.
Shimkiewicz will knock down the first one, and then she'll have the second one coming up as she was fouled by Roach. Roach has two fouls. Morgan Shank has two fouls. Second one on the way, too hard. Long rebound, fought for. Wakefield stays with it, does a good job, gets it up to Stewart. Stewart swings it out, underneath, shot good, as Grantham knocks down two on a beautiful play by the Blair Bears. Very little dribbling, three passes, and there you go. Because you can pass the ball faster than you can dribble.
Absolutely.
Down the court. Adler spots up for three, off the rim, no good. Rebound underneath. Up with a shot, and now we're going to have a foul called.
Well, let's go ahead and take a look at that, Jim, since you were talking about it. We got a replay of that.
Yeah,
too.
That's a great – I love those plays.
What we're going to have here is you're going to see there's going to be a steal in the backcourt. Wakefield pushes it up. Quick pass from Stewart right underneath, and an easy basket from the Bears. That's just how you draw it up in practice.
End of the game. For the Rams, number 54, Sarah
Schwinski. Megan Zarinski made the first one. Now she'll have the second one here. Left-hander, 38 seconds remaining. Shot on the way, off the front of the rim, and works its way back and in. So she makes two. Rosenbaum walks the ball up across half court. Stewart spreads out the offense. Jessica Shank gets it back to Nickerson. Rosenbaum drives all the way down in through, goes in, takes the shot, and it's going to be knocked away.
Challenge those trees down there.
Oh, man, Allie 5'3". Doesn't care. She goes in there and challenges them.
Well, she's always been kind of a fighter as a player. Yeah. She's not afraid to get in there and dig.
Stewart spotted up for a three, got it blocked by Henry. But Blair able to get the ball back. 16-11, Blair leading, 10 seconds remaining. Nickerson sets the pick. Rosenbaum drives around, goes in for the layup, no good. Rebound tipped out, and Blair's going to retain possession with 2.9 seconds remaining underneath their own basket. What a move by Allie Rosenbaum.
Well, that's what you do. You get that big person running at you, put the ball on the floor. They can't recover quick enough.
Stewart, three from the corner cut, right at the buzzer. Taylor Stewart knocks down her second three here in the first quarter. And the Blair Bears go up 19-11.
Wow, that was amazing, Jim. Let's go ahead and take another look at that while we got a minute here. You got 2.9 seconds. The key here is, as you see, as we get this started here, it's going to be Taylor Stewart taking the ball out underneath. Two quick passes, and then they pick for her, coming back to the corner. Gets a clean release, gets her feet under her again. And as you see, nice, nothing but bottom of the net, just like you draw those up. Coach has got to be pleased with that play right there.
Checking in for the Bears, number 14, Maddie.
Yeah, and those are great plays, good quick movement with the ball. And that's the key. You get that ball moving quicker than the defense, and then that gives, well, Stewart that time plenty of time in that corner to catch and shoot, and she's very adept at doing that, and voila, Blair's up 19-11. Stewart, 8 points already here in the first quarter. And we'll take it. Thanks for joining us, Two Rivers Bank. Also, Cargill, Sid Dillon Chevrolet, Mack, Mid-America Computer Corporation, Blair Basketball Club, and Herder Orthodontics. Instant replay now for you.
We got it about a handful of times already in that first quarter.
Yeah.
I'll try to do it the best I can here. I'm just one guy with one camera.
Adler
knocks down a three. And one computer and one piece of software. So.
Yeah. Well,
so far it's not been so too far. Awful bad. So.
Allie Rosenbaum goes in and loses the ball. Got the screen, but nothing there. Lost the ball out of bounds, and so now Ralston will have the ball back. They're down to the Blair Bears 19-14 with 7:36 remaining. Adler brings the ball up. Knocked down a three the last time down the court. Inside, little left-handed hook, no good. Rebound and tipped away. Commit comes down with it on the far side. Maddie Commit now in the ball game for the Blair Bears, 5'3 junior. Stewart gets the pick on the left side. Top of the key, Commit. Rosenbaum, right side, looks, feeds it inside. Going in, ooh, had the shot. Nice little jump shot by Grantham, but that
bothered
height.
A little bit that height again.
Yeah, it always does.
Kind of rushed that shot, trying to get it up before the shot blocker got there.
Henry has the ball way out front. Hands it over. Gaz now looks, swings it. Adler gets the ball stolen away from Rosenbaum, and then Adler comes back and fouls. Well, busy hands in there by Allie Rosenbaum.
And coach will call that a frustration foul, too. You made a mistake dribbling the ball, gave it up, and then out of frustration, you took a slap at it trying to get it back and got a foul. So that's what you call a frustration foul and a coaching moment there for the young lady. Don't compound a mistake by making another one.
Shank brings it in. Morgan goes all the way in, takes the shot, no good. Rebound fought for. And Shimowitz will bring that one down.
Well, these guards from the Bears are very aggressive, going right at those shot blockers.
Oop, now Allie Rosenbaum's going to get called for that foul. Rosenbaum picked up her first foul, and that'll be the number 7 foul on the Blair Bears. So going to the line, shooting 1-1 now.
Well, and coaches will tell you, for those young players at home, the best thing you can do to a shot blocker as a guard is get into them before they get a chance to get set and before they get a chance to go up and block your shot. If you get into them, get into their chest, and keep them on the ground, they can't block near as many shots. And it's pretty clear that this Bears team understands that because they're attacking these shot blockers. They're not sitting back trying to fall away. They're going right at them.
Zerinsky at the line again. Megan, left-hander. She'll shoot 2, fouled in the act. First one up, no good. Game for the Bears, number 33, Dallas Roach. 19-14, Blair leading. Second free throw on the way, no good. Roach, nice job, got the rebound. And then the foul will be called on Gaz. That will be her first. It might be Gaze. I don't know, it looks like Gaz, but it might be Gaze. Rosenbaum, free throw line in the corner. Roach, Rosenbaum, shot on the way. Good. Allie Rosenbaum knocks down 2. And I can remember Allie Rosenbaum is good on if she just gets the ball and shoots. You know,
yes.
No hesitation. Just catch it and put it up. She's really good at that quick shot.
Well, she's definitely improved her shooting stroke.
Yeah.
She was a pretty good athlete for a while, but she kind of struggled a little bit with that form. And you could see that form right there was really good.
Molly Nickerson brings the ball up, gets it out to Rosenbaum. Rosenbaum goes all the way in, and then Dallas Roach on the back side couldn't finish the shot, but she's going to go to the line and shoot 2. And there again, very competitive, upset herself for missing the shot. But so Megan Zerinsky will be her second foul.
Well, let's go ahead and take a look at that too quick. We see the drive by Rosenbaum on the right side. Pushes the ball into the paint and then finds Dallas on the backside for a good look at a basket. Nothing to do for Rawlson but to foul.
Yeah. And she came close to making that one. And Kylie Gosker now comes in, 5'11 junior. Dallas missed the first one. She'll have the second one coming here. Second one on the way and too hard. No good. Rebound pulled down. Shimkiewicz gets the ball over to Henry. Henry now walks the ball down the court. Adler not in. Commit trying to steal that ball away and forces Henry to lose it. And then again, and now we'll have a foul called as Commit would not let go. She just continued to go after it.
And what you're starting to see here is these guards from the Bears understand now that they've got quicker hands.
Yeah.
And Ralston is struggling a little bit handling the ball out on out on the perimeter. So they're getting right in their face and making them have to dribble under pressure.
1-1, Hendry, first one, no good. Ooh, rebound coming down hard was Commit. And that's got to hurt.
I think she may need a minute.
Yeah.
She came down pretty awkward right there.
Yeah. Boy, I tell you, Maddie Commit is a tough young lady. Excellent shortstop.
Well, that's one of those things.
No give up in her.
Yeah, it was one of those things. She hit the ground. She let go of the ball because there was something.
Yeah, something was not right.
Something was not right. Mark Quickle, our announcer slash trainer, and he's a very good trainer. Don't take that the wrong way. He's an excellent trainer. He's going to take a look at her and see what we got going.
Yeah. Inbounds, and it's great to have him here. Oh, that's travel. Yeah, no doubt about it.
Drug that pivot foot.
Yeah, drug it. No shot. So Blair gets the ball back. 21-14, 5:14 remaining. Hope to see Commit back in action. Dallas Roach tries baseline, steps back out, gets it out. Stewart over. Shank goes into the paint. Little short jump shot, no good. Shimkowitz grabs the rebound, brings it over. Adler back in for the Ralston Rams. 4:47 remaining here in the first half. And a little travel by Adler. She made a move. And then made a really good move. But you
can't
do that.
Well, that's what we were just talking about. You know, they don't always – Russell's not always that clean with the ball in their hand, so the Bears are going to pressure them.
Yeah, long in the corner to Stewart. She's got to kick the ball back out. Skip pass to Roach. She's going to spot up for three. That'll be too deep. Ball gets away, and Shank comes up with it, takes the shot, can't finish. But she'll go to the line to shoot two. So the foul will be on Zerinsky, Sarah. Zerinsky will pick up her second foul. And Morgan Shank at the line to shoot two. First one up, no good.
Yeah, let's go ahead and take a look at that rebound. Long shot, bounces around, and quick hands from Shank and gets right back in there. Almost gets that to go.
Yeah. Molly Nickerson ready to come in for Morgan Shank. And Shank will have her second free throw here. Second one on the way. Good. Blair Bears have gone cold a little bit here in the second quarter, but still lead 22-14. Both teams only scoring 3 points here in the second. Three on the way by Hendry, and just as I say that, Hendry knocks down a three.
Nice little pick and pop right there, right at the top of the key. Got her free, and they found her for that open three.
22-17. Blair still leading. Roach gets it. Nickerson pops along two. Boy, that's quick. And that's a good shot. Nickerson knocking down two. Little feed. Shimkowitz will kick the ball back to Hendry. Ooh, Rosenbaum almost comes up with that one. Adler stops, takes the shot, no good. And now we'll have a foul on Gosker.
They say no shot, but with nine fouls, that's going to be our 10th foul, so this is going to go ahead and be two shots anyway.
Yeah. So Gosker with her first. Two shots. Shimkowitz will be at the line. First one up, and no good. Second one on the way, and that one's good. Well, Ralston has missed five free throws here in the second quarter, and that would put them within one here, the Blair Bears, but 24-18. Rosenbaum, Stewart, another three on the way. Got it.
Boy, she got a smooth stroke, doesn't she, Jim?
Yeah, Taylor Stewart starting to feel that stroke here, and it's her third three here in the first half. 3:11 remaining. 27-18. Shimkowitz goes top of the key. Rosenbaum comes up with a steal. Adler grabbed her shirt, but got away with it. And then Rosenbaum got it blocked. Backside, Dallas Roach. Boy, and there's what I got to tell you. I've watched Dallas Roach here a little bit. And Roach has a great sense to get herself somewhere in a position to get the ball. I mean, I don't know how many times I've seen her just, you know, somebody is in trouble and she's right there to get a pass and a shot. And that's
well,
the
let's
key.
Go ahead
that's
and watch great... that, what you're talking about, Jim, right here.
Yeah.
Ralston's got the ball at the other end. We get a steal from Rosenbaum. Looks like she's going to have a layup. So good hustle from Ralston getting back. Gets it blocked, but she gets it right back. And like you said, right there, Dallas Roach, right in the right spot. Like you said, seems to do it every time.
Yeah. And that is a key. And that's a good thing to remember is that you've got to come up and down that court. You know, get down the court, get up down the court, because you never know what's going to happen. You know, if Roach had, if she was lazy and decided not to get down that court.
She's like, oh, well, Rosenbaum's got a layup.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, Ralston hustles down, gets the block.
That's
Rosenbaum
right.
gets the rebound, and then she would be stuck there.
Stuck, yeah.
And we, you know, you see that at times with teams. You know, teams that aren't hustling, you see somebody get stuck under the basket, and you're like, oh, man, we were close there.
Yeah.
Well, if you're hustling, close becomes a bucket.
2:51 remaining here in the first half. Blair leading 29-18 over the Ralston Rams. Thanks for joining us here today on American Broadband Channel 97, 98 HD. We appreciate it. Adler guarded by Rosenbaum. Boy, Rosenbaum all over. Coming to the ball. Good job by Zerinsky. Shot no good. Shot on the way. No good. Rebound by Gosker, and we're going to have a jump ball. Shimkowitz could not make that short shot, and she's upset at herself going back. Jump ball, alternating possession. Blair comes with the ball. Rosenbaum brings it up. Stewart feeds it in the corner. Roach right back to Stewart. Stewart top of the key. Rosenbaum gets around the defense, goes in, kicks it. Good job by Roach. Comes in, misses the shot, but boy, what a nice play by the Blair Bears. Adler brings it up, picked up by Rosenbaum.
Well, and again, Roach making herself available along the baseline.
Yep.
Gave Rosenbaum an outlet for that pass.
Henry feeds it inside. Roach, anticipation. Now throws it away. Going in for the shot, no good. Gosker comes down with it, and now we'll have a foul as Zerinsky comes back and causes the foul.
Fouls on number 50, Megan Zerinsky. That's her.
You know what, Jim? Let's go ahead and take a look at this sweet real quick here. I mean, we're going to see Roach get a steal. Yeah. Nice anticipation. Starts to travel, so throws the ball away, but then comes back and gets the block and then forces a frustration foul from Ralston. I mean, come on. What a great play from that young lady.
1-1 here for Gosker. First one up, no good. Rebound tipped around. Henry comes down with it for the Ralston Rams.
And that's why coaches love players that hustle.
Yeah.
Because she could have easily given up on that play.
Oh, yeah.
Ralston would have had an easy layup, but she didn't. She went back over there, forced a block, and then forced a foul. It's just
1:29 remaining in the first.
That's why you never give up on a play.
Henry, nice turnaround jump shot, no good. Roach comes down with a rebound. Off and running. Roach brings it up on the right side, kicks it. Stewart spots three on the way, no good. Rebound fought for. Gaze on the ground, and now Dallas Roach will tie her up, but it's going to go to Ralston. Clara Gaze, the 6'1 senior.
Well, and you can start to see it's infectious. You see Roach, you know, making some plays, hustling up and down the court, diving on the floor, even Molly Nickerson right in there. She's always been a hustler too, but,
yeah.
You know, everybody starts to do it, and you get a lot of good things happening for your team.
Adler guarded by Rosenbaum, stops her dribble. Henry now. Top of the key, that should be just a two.
Yeah, they got rid of two.
Yeah, good, because her foot was on the line.
Well, I think the scorekeeper gave her a three, but the ref was definitely signaling a two.
Yeah, nice shot. Drops down by Grantham. Grantham knocks down two. Adler brings the ball up. looks, and now we're going to have moving screen.
Scorekeepers are calling him over right there, seeing if that was a two or a three.
That's her first foul. Right now they've got it 31-21.
They just gave the definitive decision to the scorekeeper. Looks like he's trying to get that one off of there, and he did. It's down to 20 now.
Shank brings the ball up for the Blair Bears. Moves on the left side, goes in for the layup, gets pushed just a little bit. There's Adler, flips it over to the far side, running the ball down as Zerinsky passes it inside. Shimkiewicz with a nice play. Turn with the left hand and knocks it down, and she'll go to the line to try to complete that three-point play. And Shimkiewicz is working hard in there. Foul on Gosker. That's her second. Free throw up. No good. Rebound pulled down by Roach. Gets the ball out. Morgan Shank brings the ball up for the Blair Bears. Gets the pick from Gosker. Shank goes all the way in and loses the ball out of bounds.
And your score half, Bears.
So that's the halftime, as a nice drive by Morgan Shank couldn't hang on to it. And that's going to end the first half, as the Blair Bears leading now 31-22 over the Ralston Rams. We'll take a quick break. We'll be right back with more Blair basketball right here on BlairSports.net and American Broadband Channel 97, 98 HD.
Hi, I'm Vanessa Williams. There's so many things kids have to be good at these days. It's hard to stop and think about how something like learning music can help them in the future. Music helps kids because it's a performing art, and children need to learn to perform well so they can succeed in society. Getting an 85% on a math test is pretty good, but hitting 85% of the right notes during a concert isn't good enough for most music students or their teachers. A special kind of practice and preparation goes into the discipline of performing music, and it helps kids develop habits that will allow them to perform better in all areas of their lives.
A PSA brought to you by MENC, the National Association for Music Education. Music, part of a sound education.
Hi, I'm Vanessa Williams. There's so many things kids have to be good at these days. It's hard to stop and think about how something like learning music can help them in the future. Music helps kids because it's a performing art, and children need to learn to perform well so they can succeed in society. Getting an 85% on a math test is pretty good, but hitting 85% of the right notes during a concert isn't good enough for most music students or their teachers. A special kind of practice and preparation goes into the discipline of performing music, and it helps kids develop habits that will allow them to perform better in all areas of their lives.
A PSA brought to you by MENC.
Welcome back. Halftime right here for you, as we've got some cheerleaders out there. Little dancers going on out there for the Blair Bears, and it's great to see that. A lot of dancing.
Looks like the kindergartner's out there right now.
trying to get them off. Here they go. Boy, the future dance and cheerleaders right there. Oh, the first grader's coming up. We'll kind of let them entertain us a little bit here at halftime, as the Blair Bears lead 31-22 over the Ralston Rams. Second game for the Blair Bears. Second game for Ralston. Take a look at it. We got the first graders coming in here. We had the kindergarten.
Yeah, we had the kindergartners. This is going to be the first graders.
They're all going to line up here.
They went in this morning at about 9:30. Practice for an hour and 45, and then.
Jeez, I'd be tired by that then.
Yeah. And mom and dad came and watched a little bit of what they had going, and then they got here at like 2 o'clock today to practice some more. So
the first graders.
Let's hear it for the second graders.
Right here at halftime. They're going to go all the way up to seniors, or is it?
I think they're going to stop at third grade.
Third grade. All right. Think this is it?
I think so.
I think I see somebody down there that we might know.
Yeah, I do have a daughter down there in the second grade. Jim gets to know her pretty well. She likes to spend a lot of time
That's
up
right.
here.
She
comes to pretty
job.
Much every basketball game. So
she keeps us pretty straight and narrow, no doubt about that. She makes sure we have the right stuff. And she's a good gal. Second grade. I wonder who picks out all the music.
Getting a little kick line going there.
That's
Jim.
Right, hey.
Good job, second graders.
Great job by the second graders. Looking good.
I know she's been looking forward to that for months.
When do they start? They start a long time working with them, or do they go to, is this just
it's just a one-day event.
One-day event.
Yeah, they usually do one in the fall. I don't know if they got one done this year or not, but they usually do one in the fall and then one in the winter. She's been to a few of them, and she always looks forward to them.
Now we're up to the third grade, and they are lined up. Boy.
I think this broadcaster is going to have to go pick up a young lady because I don't think they'll let her leave.
Yeah, they probably won't. They probably won't have. So you better go.
So I will return if the camera doesn't move for the first few minutes. You know why.
It's all right. We'll just do audio here for a while. But thank you so much for joining us here tonight, this afternoon. Double hitter for you. Just a reminder, Blair girls playing right now. They lead the Ralston Rams 31-22. Blair Bears coming in here just shortly. Right now, we've got this halftime entertainment going on. Halftime entertainment here in Blair, Nebraska, where you're watching all the live action. And the Blair Bears doing a great job here today at the halftime as they lead 31-22 over the Ralston Rams. As we are here at halftime, and of course the boys will follow coming up here after this. Last year, the Blair Bears won 50-33 and the Ralston Rams coming off of a 4-18 record, the Blair Bears at 10-13. Right now, the Blair Bears able to get up and down the court a little quicker than the Ralston Rams, and getting that rebound and getting things going is always a key factor, no doubt about it. And we take a look at the halftime stats as the Blair Bears led 19-11 at the end of the first quarter, and then leading here at halftime 31-22. They outscored the Ralston Rams only 12-11 in that second, but still lead 31-22. Scoring wise, individually, Adler has 3 points so far in the day for the Ralston Rams. Randy Henry has 5 points. Shimkowitz, the 6'2 center, has 10 points so far. Zerwinski, Megan, she has 2 points so far. And then Sarah Zerwinski has 2 points also. So that is the scoring for the Ralston Rams. For the Blair Bears so far today, Allie Rosenbaum has 2 points. Shank has 5 points. Grantham came off the bench and she added 4 points. Nickerson poured in 2 points. Wakefield has 3 points. Dallas Roach has 4 points. And Taylor Stewart leads the scoring with 11 points for the Blair Bears. So that is the scoring right now for the Blair Bears. And for the Ralston Rams, halftime 31-22. Thanks for joining us. Sid Dillon, Chevrolet, Cargill, Mack, Mid-America Computer Corporation, Blair Basketball Club, Herder Orthodontics, Jim Ralph Agency, Blair Real Estate, Two Rivers Bank, Washington County Bank, Heartland Family Dentistry, Nannan and Hart Physical Therapy, leader in sports medicine for over 20 years. American Broadband, your hometown internet, cable television, telephone provider. American Broadband, serving all of your communication needs. BlairSports.net is the website to go to listen to all the live action. Also on American Broadband, channel 97, 98. And you can go to YouTube. It would be youtube.com/BSDN. Live. And you go there and you'll be able to watch and listen to all the live action of the Blair Bears. And there's no one else that you're going to be able to watch and listen to the Blair Bears than right here on BlairSports.net and American Broadband Channel 97, 98. A little bit of instant replay coming to you today, and see if we can keep that going. Thanks to Shane Morris working on that. And looks like you're back. Did you get her all distributed? She's ready. Well, that was fun. Halftime, little halftime entertainment.
I almost didn't make it back. I haven't run that fast in a long time. Yeah. And I wasn't running very fast.
And we don't have any oxygen up here, so please do not pass out. I don't think I want to give mouth-to-mouth.
What are you trying to say, Jim?
Well, I'm just saying.
I'm not saying, I'm just saying.
I'm just saying. And I would probably do it if I had to, but
don't make me.
Don't make me. 31-22, we're at halftime with the Blair Bears leading over the Ralston Rams. Blair boys will be coming up next. And, of course, got a lot of ball games coming up for you here in December. Blair Bear's getting ready to second half, and Blair will have the ball to begin the second half. Omaha Duchesne will be the next tip-off for the girls. That will be on Thursday the 11th, and it's a busy Thursday, Friday, Saturday, three games in a row. Friday will be at Waverly. That's a girl-boy matchup, and then Harlan comes to town to take on the boys on Saturday. Blair with the ball to start things out. Wakefield baseline shot off the front of the rim. No good. Shinkowitz gets the rebound, brings it up. 31-22, Blair leading. Adler has the ball for the Ralston Rams. Zerinsky gets it out to Henry. Adler feeds it underneath. Shot blocked by Wakefield. Boy, with three fouls, and she goes up and makes a nice block. Stewart swings it. Rosenbaum in the corner. Nickerson spots up. Three on the way. Gets it. Oh, to two. Had her toe on that line, so Nickerson knocks down a long two.
Well, that's good to see. Boy, she usually plays inside, but she can step outside and stretch that defense. Really opens up those lanes for Shank and Dallas to be able to drive. And Rosenbaum, too.
Yep. Adler, top of the key. Henry on the left wing. Gaze has it on the right side. Adler spots up, lets the three go, and she knocks down a three. Adler had 1-3 in the first half and now duplicates that right away, and it's 33-25. Shank, baseline, Nickerson swings it over. Stewart in the corner, shot no good. And Shimkowitz will be called for the foul. Going to shoot two. It'll be her second foul. Stewart will be at the line. First one up and good. Pours in her 12th point of the day so far.
She's having a pretty good game here.
Yeah. Rims in and out. Rebound, Gaze kicks it out to Adler. Adler brings it up for the Ralston Rams. 34-25, Blair leading. Here in the early going of the third, Henry. Shimkowitz, top of the key. Adler takes the pick, goes all the way around, takes the shot, 15-footer, no good. Shank gets the rebound on the backside. Takes advantage of Nickerson, makes a nice pass. Rosenbaum goes up, and she is hammered. Henry will pick up her second foul. I tell you, Allie Rosenbaum took a shot there, but I got to tell you, she is tough. At the line, she'll shoot two. First one up, good. Stretch those toes on that shot. She's really reached.
You know, you don't want to go over the line, and
no,
she didn't, but
no. Yeah.
By every little millimeter.
Second one, no good. Gaze comes down with a rebound for the Ralston Rams. Adler will walk it up, gets it across half court, goes to the right wing, looks, swings it. Zerinsky gets it right back to Adler. Adler goes baseline, stops, kicks it back. Three on the way, off the rim, no good. Long rebound, tipped around. Ooh, Morgan Shank, you would think, ooh, almost a jump ball. She had her hand on it, and no call. Henry gets it over. Zerinsky will feed it inside. And there's an easy two by Shimkowitz as she'll knock it down. You got to get around her and play in front. Nickerson goes baseline, then kicks it back out. Shank goes in, 15-footer on the way. No good. Rebound as Shimkowitz goes over the top of Wakefield, knocks it out of bounds. Shimkowitz with that long reach. Ball inbounds to Wakefield. Gets it. Stewart made a nice fake. 15-footer draws three people. Oh, nice play by Rosenbaum. What a good head fake. Comes around, spots up, and knocks down that 12-footer.
Well, having a couple senior guards on the court to go with that young sophomore Shank really puts a calming influence on this Bears offense right now.
That's a good point. 37-27, Blair leading by 10, 4:55 remaining in the third. Adler has it on the right side. Undercut, nice job coming across. Henry gets it blocked. Here comes Shank, brings it up. Crosses over, goes on the left side. And we're going to have a foul called on Ralston as Adler will pick up her third foul. And we're going to have a timeout called by Ralston. That looks like a 30-second timeout. As Adler picks up her third foul, 4:43 remaining here in the third. Blair hanging on to a 10-point lead.
Well, let's go ahead and take a look at that block by Shank. Using her athleticism down in the paint on the big on the big post player from Ralston. Just gets up in the air and times it perfectly and gives her no shot at making that basket. Excellent job using that athleticism.
What a nice move by Rosenbaum down here on the right wing. Got that head fake, got everybody up and stepped
well,
to
we can
the
go ahead
spot,
and take a look at that one down. Too since you're talking about it.
Yeah, let's take a look. I like that one.
She, you know, we got Shank driving down. Well, this one was the foul just a little bit ago. I don't think I have the replay on that one. Sorry about that, Jim.
It's all right. That happens.
That was a foul where Rosenbaum got fouled underneath in the trees.
Dallas Roach knocking the ball, keeping it loose. Rosenbaum comes back with it, makes a nice move again. Inside, backside. Drew the defense. Wakefield there. 39-27.
Excellent job. And having this ability with Rosenbaum and Roach and Shank to be able to drive and penetrate really just opens up the lanes on a defense.
Stewart will be called for the foul as Zerinsky got the pass inside. She'll go to the line and shoot two. Stewart picks up her first foul. First one on the way, no good. Sarah Zerwinski had 2 points in that first half. At the line here, 39-27, Blair leading. Second one on the way and good. Shank brings the ball up, gets it across half court. Man-to-man defense by the Ralston Rams. Wakefield sets a nice pick. Shank comes into the paint. Roach goes baseline, gets underneath, shot no good. Backside rebound pulled down by Adler. Adler brings the ball up.
Well, and as they get more and more comfortable on a varsity basketball court, those shots for Shank and Roach will start to fall a lot more often. You see them getting to the rim a lot in this game, and if they're able to continue to do that throughout this season, you'll start to see a lot of them shots fall and put a lot of pressure on opposing defenses. And then with shooters like Taylor Stewart out on the perimeter, you can really put a defense in a quandary.
Nice box out by Wakefield. Kicks the ball up for Roach. Roach slams into the
I didn't think she had any chance to get in that ball.
I didn't either, and somehow she saved it.
Wasn't anybody else there, but she saved it.
And it was underneath her own basket, so that's a good save. Underneath, a little step through, turnaround shot by Zerwinski, knocks down two. And it's 39-30. Cut the lead to nine. 3:09 remaining. Rosenbaum, nice move, goes to the basket and knocks down two. Quickness. Boy, she is so quick.
Well,
draws
that's what I talk about. You know,
off you go.
Roach and Shank are sophomores, but Allie's a senior. So when she makes that move, she's able to get it all the way to the rim.
Yeah. Henry on the right wing, guarded by Shank. Shimowitz takes a 15-footer, no good. Roach comes down with the rebound, takes off, brings it up on the near side, crosses over, gets to the top of the key, kicks the ball back to Shank. Shank swings it over. Rosenbaum comes off the pick, gets it to Wakefield. Wakefield goes baseline, backside, tries to get it to Roach, and it's going to go to the Ralston Rams. Jessica and Morgan Shank both into the game now.
Let's go ahead and take a quick look at that drive by Allie while we got a break here. In the corner, pump fake drives, easy basket for her.
Oh,
great job.
That is so nice. Adler brings the ball up. Henry has it on the left side. Swings it inside. Zirinsky tries to go underneath. Shot no good. And now Wakefield's going to pick up the foul. So Wakefield will have her fourth foul. 41-30, 2:09 remaining. Zirinsky will be shooting two. The lefty, first one up. Good.
A little bit of a friendly roll there on the road.
Yeah. 41-31. Second one coming up here. Shot on the way and good. She had 2 points in that first half, already has four. 2:07 remaining. Shank brings it up. Rosenbaum. Gosker now in for Wakefield. Morgan Shank on the right side. Stewart spots up. Three on the way. No good. And Stewart gets hammered. And the ball goes up.
And Stewart is down.
Yeah.
It looked like one of her own players fell into her as she was coming down.
Gosker came out and everybody banged into each other and then fell into her. Coach Ekwall's trying to
plead his case.
Plead his case, but 41-32. I think her knee might have been hyperextended, and then, boy, that hurts. Somebody falls in, and let's just hope that it's just a minor hyperextension. I did not see. I saw Gosker kind of fall towards it, but I didn't see if anybody else. I don't know if you have that on. Well, I'm not
well,
sure we want to watch it
for.
Anyway. But 41-32. Blair leading with a little timeout here is Taylor Stewart now down. 1:50 remaining in the third.
Yeah, we're gonna be able to see this here a little bit.
And they got her up, and she's not putting any weight on that right leg. But
well, we can go ahead and take a look at it here at home. You see her pop out, and the picker gets shoved right into her, falls back, and bangs her in the knee pretty darn hard. And that's going to hurt.
And you can't run through that screen. I mean, you
no,
have to
and,
go
and
around
it should have been
it.
A. It wasn't a foul on Taylor. It
no.
should have been a foul
well,
on the person screening.
Right.
And
yeah.
I think that's what they called here because she is shooting baskets now.
Yeah. This one's up as Nickerson knocks it down. And so Nickerson was setting the pick. I thought it was Gosker, but it was Nickerson setting the pick. And second one up, no good. So she makes one of two.
I'm not sure what that call was there.
I'm not sure either. Now we turn around, double foul. This is weird.
Yeah,
now
interesting.
We're going to have a shooting two for, I don't think I've seen this before. Henry will shoot. First one up, good.
But, yeah, definitely should have been a foul on them trying to fight through that pick.
Yeah, because you can't do that, and then I don't know what.
They basically shoved the picker to the ground and fell into Taylor.
Out of
unfortunate set of circumstances. You don't see that all that often, so we wish her well. Hope everything's okay down there.
Yep.
It looks like she banged her knee on her on the.
Yeah.
Gosker banged her head on Taylor's kneecap, so maybe it's just a quick bruise that she'll be able to recover from.
Shipkowitz comes off that pick underneath and knocks down two. So it's 42-36 as Ralston's starting to try to work their way back here. Nice pick. Nice roll. Pick and roll. Nickerson knocks down two and a nice recognition there by Roach again. 44-36. 1:18 remaining. Blair leading. Adler goes baseline. Stops. Pops the long two. Misses everything. Nickerson will get the rebound. Bring it down on the near side. stops, looks, kicks it out to Shank. Shank swings it. Roach goes baseline, left side, goes up for the shot, and she'll shoot two.
And Roach just really has a nice understanding of when to push, when to, I mean, she, it seems like she's always hustling, but she also has a nice knack of knowing when to slow down and be a little bit patient.
Dallas Roach
just plays a really smart game so far to here tonight from what I've seen.
5'8 sophomore knocks that one down, had 4 points in the first half, but to me, a lot of what Roach does is that
extending possessions. Extending,
yeah, the, you know, recognition, the anticipation.
Finds open looks. Yeah. Always makes herself available.
Yeah. Steps in on that backside, help side for defense. Adler guarded by Rosenbaum. Henry, top of the key. Feeds it inside, and now we're going to have 3 seconds called. Shinkowitz staying in that lane way too long. It was more than 3 seconds, but then I understand that's 46-36. You got to give him position. And here goes Shank. Goes in under the trees and gets that shot off somehow. Went around Shimkowitz, and if she would have made that, Adler brings it up. 10-point lead. Blair Bear, 46-36. 24 seconds remaining. Shimkowitz gets it. Henry spots up. Three on the way. No good. Backside rebound. Roach comes up with it, turns, flips it out for Shank. Shank, nice hesitation, goes in on the right side and knocks down two. Morgan Shank really set up Henry on that drive. 4 seconds remaining. Adler will fly a three-pointer, and that's going to go out of bounds. Blair gets it with 0.7 seconds remaining here in the third. Just get the ball in, and that's about it. Shank's in a stand, hang on to it. Time runs out, 48-36. Blair Bears leading here. We'll take that break. We'll be back with more Blair basketball right here on BlairSports.net and American Broadband Channel 97, 98 HD.
Hey, I'm Patty Loveless. Remember how excited you were as a kid to go back to school at the end of summer? Seeing old friends, making new ones, getting new books and a new locker, a clean slate. And music class, that special room where you went to sing and perform with your friends and learn all sorts of interesting stuff about great composers and instruments and different kinds of music. We remember our music teachers because they were so passionate about helping us to learn to love music. They helped spark a love for listening to notes and voices and rhythms that continues to enrich our lives even today. Know what? I bet your kids feel the same way about music class. Ask them and make sure they get involved.
Back to Blair's basketball right here on BlairSports.net and American Broadband Channel 97, 98 HD.
Let's go ahead and take a replay. Let's go ahead and take a quick look at that last play there by Shank as she drove.
Oh, that was pretty.
And I mean, we see a rebound coming off. Roach grabs the ball, flips it up to Shank. Drives, nice little hesitation in the lane, goes in for an easy layup. You can see these young sophomores and their athleticism really starting to take over this game in this fourth quarter.
And when do you learn that hesitation dribble? That's one of the first things you learn is, you know, change of speed, little hesitation. That's all she did, and it works. Turnaround shot no good by Shimkowitz, and Nickerson will pick up the foul.
Well, and one of the things that's kind of a misnomer sometimes to people about basketball is you play hard all the time. Well, you've got to be able to set people up and have a change of pace. Yeah, you want to play hard, but if you're going hard all the time, you're actually easier to defend.
To defend
because I don't know if you have another gear if you're playing with hesitation and things like that. If you're going hard all the time, I know what your top gear is, and all I have to do is beat you to the spot.
Nice rebound by Wakefield, and then it just showed there was three people out in front of everybody, and it was all Blair, but the pass a little bit long, but Blair definitely quick to the ball, and now we're going to have a foul called. So Dallas Roach will pick up her third foul. 7:25 remaining in the contest here in the fourth at 48-36, Blair leading. Ralston has the ball underneath their own basket. Zirinsky will inbound to backside, wide open, and Dallas Roach will get another foul.
And that's what you get with youngsters sometimes.
Yeah.
They get a little bit out of position, and they take a swipe at the ball instead of trying to stay in position.
Megan Zirinsky will do the honors here and shoot two. Fouled in the act. First one up, good.
And Roach is going to go ahead and take a seat here. With four fouls, you want to protect her so you can have her later in the game if you need be. This is still just about a 10-point game, so you're not comfortable by any stretch at this point.
Second one on the way, and good. Exactly 10 points, 48-38. Blair leading.
I mean, Blair's controlled pretty much throughout. They've had the lead the entire way, but with 10 points, that's not near enough to feel comfortable in a basketball game.
Yeah. Chang gets it over to Rosenbaum. Rosenbaum. And now we'll have a foul called. That's going to be on Zirinsky. Zirinsky with that foul. That'll give her three.
That's team six, so Blair will be shooting on the next foul.
Yeah. Wakefield gets it inside, and a little reach foul by Adler. Reaching in, that'll be her fourth foul. So now, 1-1 for the Blair Bears as Morgan Shank starts it out on the line. 7 points so far on the day. This one's up, off the rim, no good. Rebound. Chemowitz will bring it up. Gets it to Henry. Henry gets it over to Adler. Adler looks inside. Little flip inside, backside defense, and now we're going to have a foul called. And it looks like it'll be on Wakefield. And that'll do it for Wakefield today. And poor Bailey, tough on the inside. That's her fifth foul. 5 points on the day for Bailey Wakefield.
Well, and given the height she's matching up against and the work she's had to do, you might almost be surprised she lasted this long.
Yeah,
because, I mean, she gets in there and she grinds and she bangs. And against, the size that Ralston puts on the court, it's pretty easy to draw fouls when you're fighting like she is.
Megan Zirinsky knocks down the first one. She will have the second one coming up, 6:48 remaining. Cuts the lead to eight. 48-40. Morgan Shank brings the ball up, and there's good job as Rosenbaum comes across, and now we'll have a foul called. Had to be a foul because two referees blew their whistle.
Well, and that's something that they're emphasizing this year is those hand checks and impeding the progress of the offensive player by putting your hand on them. You can't do that anymore. They're trying to free up the game offensively a little bit here in Nebraska. And it's a good move. I've talked about it a lot in years past.
You get a hand on somebody's
I don't like that
hip.
Mug ball anymore. Yeah. I've never liked it. And they're trying to get it out of the game. It's not played that way at the next level. And, if you want players that can play at the next level, you've got to be able to do it at this level first.
Grantham, a 5'7 sophomore, ties up. Oh, man. Gets up, and Blair gets the ball on the alternating possession. Jump ball. Grantham looks. Shank steps out. Top of the key. Gets the pick. Goes the other way. 15-footer. Good. Nice float. Nice shot. So
She's
smooth.
She's so smooth with the basketball, man. Jim. So smooth.
Doesn't rush. Takes what the defense gives her, and then makes him pay for it. Adler, baseline, running layup. Chemowitz right there to clean it up and knock down two. Blair walks it up. Morgan Shank gets it across half court. Jessica Shank now swings it to Rosenbaum. Morgan steps back. Boy, makes a nice move, goes inside, goes up, gets the ball blocked. Gets underneath, and now we're going to have a timeout called by the Blair Bears. So Blair gets the timeout. with 5:49 remaining. Good job by Coach Ekwall to jump up and get that timeout because they were going to lose that possession.
Well, I believe that's our first timeout of the game. No, it's not.
No.
I take that back. I just haven't been keeping track.
Well, we haven't taken very many. We have not taken very many. 51-42. Blair leading. They have the ball underneath their own basket. See if.
Well, let's go ahead and take a look at that drive by Alley here. By Shank. Top of the key. Just nice little crossover. Pulls up at the free throw line. Easy basket.
And that's something you got to learn that, hey, I can pull up and do that besides going into those trees, and does it well. There's Shank, turns. They're going to call her for traveling.
Yeah, started to lose the ball and trying to maintain it. She lost her balance and took a little hop in there. She knows it too. She's not questioning that call at all.
51-42. Ooh, Shank almost got the steal. Henry spots up, three coming on, and now we're going to have a foul called. That'll be on Morgan Shank. So it's after the shot. Morgan Shank gets her third foul. 5:34 remaining, and Henry will go to the line. She'll shoot a 1-1. So you wonder now. Blair's getting a few players with four fouls here. First one up and good by Henry.
Well, and they can't stop what's got him here, though. They can't stop being aggressive.
That's just it. Yeah.
They can't play too cautious. You got 5.5 minutes.
Yeah.
You start slowing down now, Rolston will take this game over.
Shot no good. Shank comes down with a rebound. Brings it up. Makes the crossover. Goes in on the right side. And that will have a foul called on Henry.
Just like that, put the pressure back on him at the other end.
That's Henry's fourth foul. That'll put Morgan Shank to the line. We'll see if they'll have her shoot 2 or 1-1. Because I got a feeling she was passing, but they're going to make her shoot 2, so that's good. I don't know anything up here.
That was a shot, Jim, all the way.
Okay, yeah, all right. Shank, second free throw on the way, good. 5:27. This is the time of the game, too, that free throws become a little more difficult.
Absolutely, and, Shank hasn't always been clean at the line, but she made those two, so big free throws from the young lady.
Backside rebound pulled down by Grantham. Gets it up to Shank. Shank goes all the way in, takes a shot, no good. Boy. Good speed, just got ahead of everybody. Feed inside. Turnaround shot, Allie Rosenbaum is going to be called for the foul. Rosenbaum picks up her second foul.
Well, and the other thing, too, is we still have Taylor Stewart down on the bench talking to the trainer. And I saw Commit go off the court towards the locker room, bandaged up on her knee. So you're down a couple players that have been playing quite a bit in this game. And you've got some foul trouble, so you're right, Jim. There's some concern about depth maybe starting to creep into coach's mind here a little bit. But, again, you don't want to slow down. That's how you win basketball games.
Sarinski at the line. Second one on the way. She made the first, made them both. She is perfect from the line in the fourth quarter here so far. She has made 6. Rosenbaum brings the ball up. Shank. Kicks it over. Graham with the shot. And a good-looking shot. Just missed it. Chemowitz gets the rebound on the backside. 53-45. So, Ralston, plenty of time yet. 4:36 remaining here in the contest. Rosenbaum trying to help. Coming in, shot wide. Atler takes it. Puts it back up and good. So, all of a sudden, Ralston coming back here. 53-47. 6-point lead for the Blair Bears. Blair has slowed it down a little bit and trying to drive inside. Kosker, baseline shot, no good. Rebound pulled down by Henry. 4:08 remaining. Good job by Shank as she makes the steal at half court and then knocks it down. Morgan Shank comes away with a huge steal. 55-47. Blair leads with 4 minutes.
We're going to take a look at that real quick. Just picks her clean right at half court.
Yep.
Goes back in for the layup. Great job from Shank.
Just so patient and yet quick at the same time, and that's tough to do, is to wait for your time and then snap at it. She just did a good job there.
Like you mentioned before, it's not always necessarily about playing as fast as you can. Sometimes it's about setting somebody up. She was just kind of laid back there a little bit. Let's go ahead and watch it again while we got it. You can see her just kind of laying back a little bit like she's going to play defense and then just takes a snap at that ball, pokes it clean, and gets in for that easy layup.
And that was big right then at that time because Ralston had a little momentum coming and able to steal the ball and give Blair an 8-point lead now instead of that 6 and a possible 3-point. If they come down and knock down a 3, it could have only been a 3-point
lead. Well, they've been making some free throws.
Yes,
they
have.
They've been climbing back into this game, cut it to 6. We come down, get a nice drive, had a good look on a baseline shot, couldn't get it to fall, and they're coming back looking to make it a 4-point game and just bang. Quick little pick and easy layup.
We'll have to see if the Blair Bears pick the pace up a little bit. They're going to go full court pressure now.
Well, kind of a nuisance.
Yeah.
Forcing it into somebody else's hands besides the person that normally handles the ball.
Adler brings the ball up. She's going to go to the right wing, guarded by Rosenbaum. Ooh. Jessica Shank went for the steal. No good. Long rebound. Shimowitz gets it and puts it right back up. Shimowitz is pretty tough there. Rosenbaum gets it over to Morgan Shank. Shank gets around the defense, goes all the way in underneath, goes up for the shot. And Shimowitz will be called for the foul, I would think.
Yeah, she's the only one there.
Yeah. Lauren Shimkowitz.
Well, that's the best thing that Shank can do right now is continue to attack her.
Yep.
You get a step on him. This Bears offense hasn't looked all that clean in a half-court set, so continue to push, continue to pressure him, force him to foul you in the paint, go make some free throws.
3:30 remaining in the contest.
3:30 is an eternity in a basketball game,
absolutely.
You don't want to sit on this ball just yet.
Second one up, no good. Henry gets it over to Adler. Adler brings it up, 56-49, 7-point lead for the Blair Bears. Feeds it in. Shimowitz gets it. Lorenzi comes around. Nice block by Dallas Roach. Comes in, and there's what she adds, and it goes all the way in. Gets it to Shank. Shank makes a move, and they're going to call it for traveling. So Shank turns it right back. Nice move, but just that little
there you
pop.
See the good and the bad of the young players.
Yeah.
Great play at the other end to get the steal, then just pushes it a little too far. That's probably one you want to go ahead and back out and set something up maybe a little bit.
Henry swings at Rosenbaum. Oh, they're going to call her for on the arm. So Rosenbaum picks up her third foul. 2:54 remaining. Both teams with 10 fouls. So anybody goes to the line, they're going to be shooting two. Adler at the line. First time she's been there today. First one up and short. 56-49. Another ball game coming to you. Don't go away. We've got the boys coming up here shortly. 2:54 remaining in this one. Adler's second one on the way. Off the rim, no good. Shimowitz gets the rebound, kicks it back out. Adler spots up for a three. There's Gaze with the shot, no good. And the rebound comes back underneath the basket, and we're going to have a jump ball that's going to go to the Ralston Rams. So ball being tipped around and can't hang on to it.
Well, the downside is you didn't get the ball, but the upside is you're making them take a long time to get a basket.
Yeah. Let that clock run.
Keep that clock ticking.
Zerinsky looking to inbounds. Gaze has it. Ball gets taken away. Here comes Dallas Roach, gets it up for Shank. Shank lays it in on the left side for two. So Morgan Shank knocked down two, and there's where Roach, Shank, a little speed. You could just see. Ooh, a long three by Henry. Ooh, close. Rims in and out. Rosenbaum comes out. Here they come. It's a 3-on-2. Rosenbaum just takes it all the way in, goes up, and we got a blocking foul on Henry.
Tried to take a charge, but Rosenbaum was going past her. Didn't really get there nearly in time, and wasn't in front of her all the way either. So,
fifth foul on Henry. So Henry will foul out here. She has 8 points on the day. Henry plays well.
And she was one of the ones making it really tough for the Bears on the inside. Absolutely. She's not overly tall, but she plays really strong in the middle. And the Bears are doing it, you know, kind of struggling between, you know, the height and the size of Ralston. It was starting to bother the Bears, and Henry's definitely one of them.
Rosenbaum with two. First one up, good.
As the Bears push it back out to double digits, good sign for the Bears to be able to kind of clamp back down and push that lead back out again.
2:26 remaining. Second one on the way, and that's 10 points so far today for Rosenbaum. And it's a 60-49 lead for the Blair Bears, and we're going to have a timeout. Timeout by Ralston, I think. Yeah, full timeout. Ralston calls timeout with 2:25 remaining. Full timeout, 60-49. Thank you for joining us here tonight, or today. Gosh, I say tonight, and it's only 3:50 in the afternoon.
Not quite tonight yet.
Boys will follow after this, and the girls right now leading 60-49. Thanks for joining us right here. Cargill, Sid Dillon Chevrolet, Mack, Mid-America Computer Corporation, Blair Basketball Club, Herder Orthodontics, Jim Ralph Agency, Blair Real Estate, Two Rivers Bank, Heartland Family Dentistry, Washington County Bank, American Broadband, your hometown internet, cable television, telephone provider, American Broadband, serving all of your communication needs. BlairSports.net is the website to go to listen to all the live action. American Broadband Channel 97, 98 is HD, a great place to go and watch this and listen. Also, YouTube. Make sure you check us out there as you go to youtube.com/BSDN Live. Thank you so much for joining us. And if you want to be a sponsor, still plenty of time. You can jump on board, get a hold of John Stewart or myself or Shane Moore. So we'd be more than happy to get you going as a sponsor. Adler brings the ball up. Blair leading 60-49. 2:18 remaining in the contest. Ralston with the ball. Swinging it around. Adler, top of the key. Swings it inside. Shimowitz turnaround shot no good. And now we're going to have a foul called underneath. And the foul will be on Jessica Shank. She picks up her first.
Well, that's been quite the dynamic duo as they get to be juniors seniors. I tell you what, Jim.
Sarinski at the line. She'll shoot two. First one up, good. Continues on her streak. She has not missed here in the fourth quarter. Makes it a 10-point lead, trying to get it into that single digits. Left-hander. No good. Shimkiewicz turnaround shot good. And you're 6-2.
Well, that's a three-point play the backwards way.
Yes. Yeah. Here comes Shank, brings it up. That's Jessica. Nickerson looks, kicks it over to Rosenbaum. Rosenbaum gets inside the paint. Out to Nickerson. Baseline shot no good. Rebound by Rosenbaum. Comes in and makes the shot. Boy, I tell you.
Big rebound right there, Jim. The trees were away from the basket. And gave her an easy look at a basket right there.
She went right to the ball, got it, and went right back up. Allie Rosenbaum, 5'3 senior, getting it done out front and underneath. Ball knocked away by Morgan Shank. Shank trying to get the ball out quickly. Adler guarding her, brings it up. Rosenbaum gets the pick from Roach, swings it over. Morgan Shank in the left wing. Nickerson's going to set it up for a pick, but steps back. Want to run a little time here with 1 minute, 2 seconds remaining. Now we're under 1 minute.
Yeah, you definitely take the air out now.
Oh, yeah.
10-point lead. 52. Force them to foul you.
Jessica Schenck gets it over to Morgan Schenck. Morgan now brings it over. Top of the key. And we're going to have a foul called on Gaze, and Gaze will have the foul called on her. Clara Gaze gets her second foul. Morgan Schenck at the line. Shooting two. First one up. Good.
Well, and this Bears team is so deep at the guard position.
Yeah.
I mean, guards and even in those tweener forwards like Roach can handle the ball well enough.
Twos and the threes. And
I mean, they're so deep. You know, you've got Kmet and Stewart down right now with injury, but you still got both the Schencks and you've got Rosenbaum. And, you know, it seems like they always got one on the bench that can come in and is ready to play.
Jessica Schenck knocks the ball away, and it's going to stay with Ralston. 35 seconds remaining in this contest, 64-52. Blair leading. Adler gets the ball for the Rams. Takes the shot on the way. No good. Backside rebound. Nickerson has it. Brings it out. Turns. Gets it to Schenck. Schenck now swings it to Rosenbaum. Jessica Schenck has it way out front. Try to just run the clock here. 64-52. Morgan Schenck has it. Grantham tries to drive on the baseline. Kicks it back out. 2 seconds remaining. And then finally, Sarinski gets the foul. And that will be her fourth, but I think Ralston was
trying.
That's
actually going to be her fifth, it looks like.
Nope, I missed one then. So that's all right, but that's too bad. Sarinski playing hard here today and had an outstanding job at the free throw line. Morgan Schenck doing a fine job here today. She's at the line again. First one up, good.
Well, and you're going to see her up the line a lot this year as she handles as much as she handles the ball and as quick as she is. There's going to be a lot of teams swiping at her. Made those two. She didn't look all that clean from the line tonight, but as the season wears on, she's going to figure out pretty quick. I need to be able to knock those down regularly because I'm going to be there a lot.
Blair wins this one 66-52. We'll take a quick break. We'll be back with a wrap-up right here on BlairSports.net and American Broadband Channel 97, 98 HD.
Homework, soccer, part-time jobs, the internet. Are you and your busy kids forgetting something? Whatever you overlook, please don't forget music. Hi, I'm Vince Gill. Music study is probably the most valuable way that a student can spend time. Time spent in practicing and studying music reinforces teamwork, communication skills, self-discipline, focus, and creativity. All the qualities that the kids really need to be successful in their other schoolwork and in society. Let your kids know that music is a whole lot more than what they hear on the radio. And the more they learn about it, the more they'll enjoy listening to their favorite tunes. Then maybe they can explain to you why they think it's so cool. Hey, turn off that TV and play some music with your kids.
A PSA brought to you by MENC, the National Association for Music Education. Music, part of a sound education.
Homework, soccer, part-time jobs, the internet. Are you and your busy kids forgetting something? Whatever you overlook, please don't forget music. Hi, I'm Vince Gill. Music study is probably the most valuable way that a student can spend time. Time spent in practicing and studying music reinforces teamwork, communication skills, self-discipline, focus, and creativity. All the qualities that the kids really need to be successful in their other schoolwork and in society. Let your kids know that music is a whole lot more than what they hear on the radio. And the more they learn about it, the more they'll enjoy listening to their favorite tunes. Then maybe they can explain to you why they think it's so cool. Hey.
Welcome back to Blair Basketball right here on BlairSports.net and American Broadband Channel 97, 98 HD. And, of course, YouTube at youtube.com/BSDNLive. Thanks for joining us here today. Well, the first game is in the books as the Blair Bears win 66-52 over the Ralston Rams. And the Blair Bears really taking control of this game, never out of control, really. When you look at their first quarter, they were up 19-11. That eight-point lead really stretched it out because Ralston came back within one as Blair outscored them 12-11 in the second, but the lead is still 31-22 at half. After the third, Blair is up 17-14 leading there, but they outscored them. It's 48-36 at the end of three. And then in the fourth, the Blair Bears take it to them, and they win 66-52 here in the end. And Ralston doing a good job as trying to come back, but Blair just too fast for the Ralston Rams.
Yeah, I mean, you could see the athleticism the Bears had. They got out and ran, and they pushed the ball quite a bit. I'm just kind of going through these clips here, these highlights, so you can see how this game went. You can see how the Bears were able to kind of get out and push the ball, really put the pressure on it. Didn't always necessarily shoot all that well, but with the athleticism they put on the court, it's tough for any team to deal with.
Blair outscoring Ralston 18-16 in that fourth period, but 66-52, and they just, you know, you just keep outscoring, and by the time you get to the end, you've got that lead, and the Blair Bears win at 66-52. Individual scoring here today, as Adler had 8 points, Henry had 8 points, Megan Sarinski had 13 points, Sarah Sarinski had 2 points coming off the today, and then Shimkiewicz, leading scorer for Ralston with 20 points. For the Blair Bears, Rosenbaum had 12 points. Grantham came off the bench. She added 4 points. Nickerson had 7 points today. Good to see that production out of Molly Nickerson here today. Also, Bailey Wakefield, unfortunately, got into... points here today. She had 23 the other night, 20 today, so pretty easy to figure that one out. And the Blair Bears win 66-52, and it was a lot of hustle, just good speed up and down using what they needed to do, and it's amazing to me how they can scrap and get those rebounds and then kick it out, because the rebound really starts the whole thing for their fast break. You can't get the rebound, you're not going to go anywhere, so...
You're right, Jim, and that's the way this team's going to have to play. They're very, very deep at the guard position. I think if we were got a chance to talk to Coach Ekwall, I don't see him down there. I'd like to talk to him, but I don't know if we'll get a chance. He would say the same thing. We've got a lot of guards. We're pretty deep there. We're pretty quick there. So we're going to get out and push, and we're going to force the other team to run with us. And, you know, he's done it pretty much every year. Because he's had the teams to do it.
Yeah.
So that's, I mean, that's good recognition. You don't know if that's the kind of team his ideal team would be, but that's what he has, so that's what he uses, and he does a good job with it.
Well, that's just it, you know, and a lot of times in high school you're gonna have to deal with what you're gonna have to deal with, and so that's part of the whole deal. But at least today, Blair Bears looking good. As
well, you know, ideally you have Patrick Ewing at center, Michael Jordan on the wing, and Derrick Rose running point. You know, you got all this stuff going on, but you know, in high school it's not always ideal.
No, it's not. No doubt about it. Blair boys are out warming up as they will take on the Ralston Rams. Blair coming off a 6-17 year last year. And now they turn around and Ralston Rams 11-11 last year. Perfect 500. Ralston lost their first contest against York, and so they come in at 0-1. The Blair Bears have not played. This will be their first. Last year, Blair lost this one 68-62 in a close contest against the Ralston Rams. See if the Blair Bears can do something a little different this year. But that's how it goes. We'll have to go down and get the lineups, get things ready for this second game. But if you just joined us, the Blair girls won 66-52. Congratulations to them. And now we're getting ready anyway for the Blair boys. I'm going to run down and get that starting lineups and Shane, you can entertain everybody, or we can just shut it down. We can just have
I got to make a couple changes up here, so we'll probably go off the air for a little bit as I make some changes. Get ready for the boys' game.
Either that, I got to
get things started up.
Yeah, we can play.
Well, I got to shut it down for a little bit.
Oh, we're going to shut it down, and then we'll be back.
And stuff on YouTube.
All right.
We'll shut down for just a short bit, and then we'll be back.
Come right back. All right. You're listening to Blair Basketball right here on BlairSports.net and American Broadband Channel 97.98 HD, YouTube at YouTube.com/BSDN Live. 66-52, the Blair Bears win. Coming up next will be the Blair Boys.